Hi everyone, I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. In this video, I want to show you how to convert a Windows physical PC into a virtual machine. I'm gonna show you also how to import this virtual machine into Hyper-V, so you'll have a fully functional copy of your physical PC running into Hyper-V as a virtual machine. This operation is called P2V, and I'm gonna be performing it using a free tool from Microsoft's SysInternal suite of tools. The tool I'm gonna be using is called Disk2VHD, and it is compatible from Windows Vista up until the latest version of Windows, so you can convert like old PCs you have running Windows Vista or Windows 7, or even newer PCs that have Windows 11. The PC I'm gonna be converting in this video into a virtual machine is an old Dell PC running Windows 11. So let's start the conversion. So the first thing you need to do is to download the Disk2VHD utility from SysInternals and run it on the old computer that you want to transform into a virtual machine. So this is the old computer here. Let's open the web browser. And in the web browser, put in this URL, sysinternals.com. Here you have under Downloads, File and Disk Utilities. Click to expand it. And then here you have the utility Disk2VHD. Click on it. And then click on download here. So the utility will be downloaded. So let's open the folder where it was downloaded to extract it. Right click on it and choose extract all. Click extract and it will be extracted, and the folder where it is extracted will be opened. So for me, I'm gonna export this machine and its hard drives to a USB key. I have a very fast USB key that is 256 gigabytes. So here the USB is inserted already. I'm gonna double click this utility here, Disk2VHD 64-bit, because my operating system here is a 64-bit operating system. Click yes. And the utility will scan the PC for the drives, and it will list all the drives here. So we need to select the drives that we want to export as VHDX files to use in the virtual machine. Now, it's very important to keep the hidden partitions here selected, and the C drive, of course, it should be selected. And here also, I have another partition on the internal drive that is called E. I'm gonna keep it selected. And here, of course, I'm gonna uncheck the USB key because this is the target of my VHDX file. So I'm gonna uncheck it here. And this is also a drive that I have on my PC. And you're gonna see how, when we import the virtual machine into Hyper-V, how these drives will be created. So now for the options, it's important to keep use VHDX if you're importing the machine into Hyper-V. If you wanna import the machine into VirtualBox, uncheck this. So this way the output will be .vhd, and this way VirtualBox can read it. Here I'm gonna use Hyper-V to import it. So I'm gonna keep use VHDX. And for the use volume shadow copy, this is because to take a snapshot before it is exported so that it will be stable. Now, because I have this external drive, it will not work the use volume shadow copy. So I'm gonna keep it unchecked. For you, if you're not exporting an external drive, you can check it and keep prepare for use in virtual PC unchecked. And here you need to choose the output file. I'm gonna click on the three dots here. And here I'm gonna select my USB key. And I'm gonna change the file name here. So I'm gonna put my Win11 and I'm gonna click on save. So now we're ready to start the creation. I'm gonna click on create. This operation might take a while, so I'm gonna fast forward this video and I'm gonna come back when this operation is almost finished. Now the operation is finished, and you see here that we had the operation completed successfully. So let's close this and let me show you the output file. So you see here that you have two VHDX files. The first one contains the operating system partition and the partition that is on the same drive of the operating system. And the second one contains the external drive that I chose to export it with my machine. So now what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna switch to the PC where I have Hyper-V, and I'm gonna show you how to create a virtual machine with these drives, and you're gonna have an exact same copy of this physical old machine and a virtual machine running into Hyper-V. So this here is the USB key. I'm gonna insert it in my PC now. We need to copy the VHDX files into the PC where Hyper-V is installed. So I'm gonna open File Explorer. And then here, I know that I wanna put them under the C drive, virtual machines, Hyper-V. I'm gonna create a folder. So new folder, I'm gonna call it my Win11. And now let's copy the VHDX files into this folder. So they are here. And while the files are being copied, if you're liking this video so far, I would appreciate it if you give it a thumbs up and you subscribe to my channel. The next step is to open Hyper-V Manager, create the machine, and import these hard drives into the machine. Now I already have Hyper-V installed on my Windows 11 machine here. If you want to see how to install Hyper-V step by step, I've previously made a video on this detailing all the steps needed. So I'm going to leave a link in the description for this video in case you want to check it out. To open Hyper-V Manager, click on the search here and then key in Hyper, and then you're going to see Hyper-V Manager. Click on it. And here we need to create a new machine. So click on the new and then click virtual machine. Click on next. Name the virtual machine whatever you want. So I'm going to keep on naming it my Win 11 and then click on next. And here, because this is a Windows 11 machine, you need to select generation 2. If you are importing a Windows 7 machine, make sure to keep generation 1 selected, otherwise it will not work. So here I selected generation 2, click on next. For the memory for Windows 11, I'm gonna give it at least 8 gigabytes of RAM, so it is 8192. Click on next. So here for the connection, I'm gonna click default switch. Next, and this is an important step here. So here you need to choose use an existing virtual hard drive, and then let's click on browse. And remember, we copied the two VHDX files under my Win 11 here. So I'm gonna double click on it. And here you need to choose the first one, which has a number 0. So click on it. We're gonna attach this one later. So click on open after you select the 01, and then click on next, and then click on finish. So now the virtual machine is created. So now we need to attach the second VHDX file to it. So I'm gonna click on it to select it. I'm gonna click on settings, and here under SCSI controller, I'm gonna click on add on the right while keeping hard drive selected. And then let's browse for the hard drive, and it is under my Win 11. So here I'm gonna select the second hard drive, click on open and click on OK. So now we need to start the virtual machine. First, make sure it is selected and then click on connect, and here click on start and click on connect again. And you see here that we don't have a login, and this is simply because on the source machine, that is a physical machine, we had a pin login and it doesn't work here in Hyper-V. The simple solution for this is to click on view and then uncheck enhanced session, and you're gonna see we can log in now. So now it's asking us for the pin. I'm gonna show you how to remove all this problem. So let's put the pin. And now under the virtual machine here, you need to remove the Windows Hello so that you can connect to it in enhanced mode, and then you can put it in full screen. Go to settings, and then under settings here, click on accounts, and then click on sign in options. And here you need to disable this Windows Hello. So if we disable it, you cannot log in anymore with a pin. So you need to log in with your password. So I'm gonna disable it, and I'm gonna restart the virtual machine. And you're gonna see now that it will work in enhanced mode, and it will ask me for my password. So let's restart it. So now the virtual machine has restarted. Let me click here on view and then enhanced session. So let's log in now with the password. And you see now that it worked in full screen mode. So let me put it full screen and let's check the hard drives. So all the hard drives are here too. You have your C drive, you have your second drive, and you have your data drive. So as you saw, the conversion was really easy and it was successful. I hope that you liked this video and you found it useful. If you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel greatly. And this way, you'll not miss my future videos. I want to thank you all for watching. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.